Welcome back to the channel, everyone. Today we're doing some Tavern Brawl shenanigans for the latest Tavern Brawl Clash of the Minions. So let's have a look at the splash. No time for cowards, soldier. Playing minions gives them charge and taunt. Okay, here's the mulligan. Go, go, go. Now, I've been thinking about... I haven't played the Brawl yet, but I did have a look at the card, at the Brawl text. And I've been thinking about what's going to be powerful. Some obvious things are Divine Shield, because you get to charge. Now, I think we're taking Paladin, because Paladin gives Divine Shield. But we could be trying some other classes later on as well. So let's start off with Paladin. And we want to give as much Divine Shield as possible. Because charge and Divine Shield is a really powerful combo. Very powerful combo, because then you get to charge again, and they get taunt. Ooh, a Tyrion. He already has taunt. I think he's strong enough to just take as is. Okay, and what else works with Divine Shield? Cobalt. I think Cobalt's too gimmicky. We've got Argent Squire. I don't think Annoyatron is very good. Horse Rider is... Horse Rider already has charge. I'm hesitant to put minions that already have charge. Like, say, Scarlet Crusader, Silent Knight. Does the same thing as a Horse Rider, has more health. Silver Moon. I wonder if Silver Moon is too slow, actually. We're not taking the Crusader. I think Sunwalker... Force Tank. Yeah, let's take the Force Tank. Sunwalker... let's leave it off for now. Okay, and we are taking the Blood Knight. I would run a second Blood Knight if possible. And what else is good? So we have Divine Shield. We have Death Touch is probably good. It's not called Death Touch in this game, but the Cobra effect, Destroy, the Destroy effect. Any minion, because then you can use these guys as spot removal. We could run a BGH. My Exner is probably going to be decent. Black Knight is going to be decent because... Very strong, because everything has taunt. BGH is probably still going to come in handy at some point. And let's see here. What else did I think was good? Wind Fury. That's right. Because what's good about what's not to like about being able to Wind Fury to charge and Wind Fury? Okay, so I think. We have a lot of 3-drops, so let's actually get rid of some of them. Maybe the Silent Knight can go... I'll take the Raging. I think we probably can fit some Harpies in. I think the Squire is probably too slow, even as a Divine Shield charge, because the 1 damage charge isn't likely to make a huge difference. So if we can run any... Oh, we've got the Dragon Hawks that can charge. Actually, with charge, things that give attack, so attack buffs, abusive, and things like that would be very useful as well. Plus, the abusives themselves get charged, so give attack. We've got these. Not a fan of Lance Carrier. I think it's just undervalued as a card. Dark Hind can work as well, because the body itself gaining charge. I think I take one of the Coghammers out, because it's a little unsynergistic to have 2 Coghammers in the hand. Alright. What else do we have? Some Brewmasters? Yeah, let's run some Brewmasters. Because, again, I get to brew my protectors, I get to brew things that have their Divine Shield pinged off, and then I get to play them again for charge. Let's just try this and see how we go. Okay, I think we keep the Worgen and we ditch the rest. I wonder if my Exner is too slow, actually. I do like the fact that... There we go, we have some hard removal in the form of the Cobra. And that's pretty good. That's pretty good flexibility, actually. So consider Cobra and my Exner hard removal. Okay, I'm not coining anything out. And a question I do have, which we'll have to test for... which we'll have to test in game, is do summons gain charge? As in, you know, if you play like a Murloc Tidehunter, does that gain charge? So we can coin out a Worgen. Because although you may be ramping, we do have a bunch of hard removal in hand. Which also means that possibly BGH is overkill. Do you have the artifact? Is BGH overkill? Oh, wow. It's like a monkey. Okay, a monkey. A monkey thingo. I don't want to throw the cobra into it, actually. I think I'm just going to tote him up. The cobra is much... I want to trade it up for like a late game minion. Interesting monkey concept. Monkey druid, huh? Ramp monkey druid. I guess it could work. Now, I do have a feeling the force tanks may be a little slow, but the fact that they go 2-for-1 and they have charge, I don't know. Let's just try it first. Oh, really? Wow. Okay. Emperor? I could shielded mini bot, taunt up, or I can cobra clear this and then divine protection the cobra. Because the silver moon guardian doesn't do anything different from the shielded mini bot. The intended target was the Elise anyway. Okay, let's go mini bot and then totem up. I've been playing too much shaman. Yeah, mini bot's fine here. We can still clear the remnants of the keeper with my silver moon. Yeah, wonder what other minions might be powerful in this mode. And you know what, the one thing that I did notice, last week we had lead from the front, which was the face tank brawl, and this week we have you know, the minions tanking brawl and the charge. The thing is, both of the brawls have been collection dependent. What do I mean by that? Some of the brawls don't care what your collection is, and some of the brawls do. And it's a little disappointing that we've had collection dependent brawls 2 weeks in a row. I think previously it's usually been one. It's usually alternated. Ah, here we go. We've got the Myx now. I think it's worth developing the Myx now. And you know what, this is a cool thing? The Silverhand recruits are actually protected. Now I don't want to sacrifice a Silverhand recruit in. Yeah, I don't know why you would play a Sludge, actually, because the thing is, Sludge already has Taunt. You might as well play, yeah, something like a Sentinel. Okay, so you're going to purposely kill your Sentinel. Oh, wow. Oh, I didn't notice. Yeah, my Axner, very tanky minion. Actually, a pretty good minion in this mode, because of how much health it has. I really do like it. Okay, now what can we do? We can Silver Moon Abusive. Yeah, that works. Gives me a very neat clear. And then we can Totem Up again. And these... sorry, I keep calling them Totem Ups. But these little guys, actually, they're protected by the Taunt minions, which makes it really hard to get to them. Unless you use AoE, and there's already been one swipe that's come down. So we're looking pretty strong here. Okay, there's the second swipe. That's fine. You had to spend 4 of your mana to do that. Okay, Shredder. Yeah. I think we want to get rid of this. So I'm going to Divine Shield up the Cobra. And hopefully we can clear the Remnants. Oh, wow. That's interesting. I think we're dead. Because of the Doomsayer pop. I've got nothing to protect my face. Yeah. Maybe the tanks are too slow. Let me wonder. I think the BGH is overkill, so BGH should come out. Yeah. So the problem is, you get the big Ancient of War that goes to the face. So you're ramping to the Ancient of War that goes to the face, and that's problematic. Actually, the BGH is a good answer for that, so maybe I should keep it in. But I do seem to be missing some... Like, we could use some stronger mid-game. I have no 5 drops, I have no 4 drops. So actually, let's get rid of the Force Tanks and see what we can find in the 5 slot. Actually, one thing that I do think would be good, the Fugan and Stalag combo. So Thaddeus, here we are. We've got our 5 drops. And because they can charge, we can summon Thaddeus at will, basically. Is this better? Yeah. I think it's okay. The Wind Fury Harpies honestly might be a little weak. The Silver Moons actually might be a little weak because they don't... Like, what's the... Why not just run a Yeti? And I think... Or why not run a... why not run a... whatchamacallit? Shredder. Because it sort of does the same thing. Plus, it pushes for higher damage. It comes back... If the Shredder comes back as, like, a 3-attack minion, which is, I think, the most likely outcome... it does the same thing as the Silver Moon, so let's take this out. The Silver Moon is better with buff cards, but I'm not really running many buff cards, like Kings or anything like that. Okay, so we'll run the Shredder. Let's see how we go this time around. Okay, I think I keep the Cobra to charge and take down any big threats. Maybe the Bruise are too slow. It's hard to say. Yeah, anyway, like I was saying, the last two brawls have been collection dependent, as in you build the list. You build your list from what you have in your collection, which means that people who have are beginners or have small collections are disadvantaged. And I would have liked this week to have been, you know, a build it for you brawl, like a pre-made list or something like that. Yeah, this is going to be very difficult to deal with the mad scientist. Do I want to just push out with the brew? Yeah, let's push out with the brew. It'll at least stop the mad scientist hitting my face. The problem here is, usually, because you'd think that Death Rattle would be too slow in this mode, but the fact that they have charge, it means that you get to activate the Death Rattle as the player, as the class that plays the Death Rattle minion, such as a mad scientist. You always get to activate it when you want to. The weakness of Death Rattle minions is often your opponent gets to choose when to activate it because it's quite disadvantageous for you to activate it on your own turn. Okay, I think we push out with the mini bot because I don't want to expose my cobras just yet. Now that is not a mirror entity. So I'm thinking Death Rattle, or it could even be Freeze Mage. Seeing the mad scientist and seeing not there weren't any other plays. I'm tempted to think maybe Freeze Mage, but maybe it's too slow for this kind of because you know everything has charge, so even if you AoE it, the minion has already gained a portion of its value. Okay. Now as we wait. I did want to bring up one other thing that's not Hearthstone related, but pretty close to my... It's pretty close to home when it comes to talking about being a content creator for something like YouTube. Now, recently... I don't really want to do that. Okay, I think we'll just push out with the Cobra. The Cobra is actually quite weak just being played on its own. But at the very least, it'll absorb like a Frostbolt or a charging minion into it. Okay, so like I was saying, recently, I think yesterday, time of recording is the 25th of Feb. Yesterday, Team 4-Star, and I'll put a link in the show notes to their website. Team 4-Star... they're a group of content creators on YouTube that, how do I say, their specialty is making Dragon Ball Z parody episodes, and they use the clips of the actual series to make parody videos. Doing here. I think we can do this. Join or die. Not on my watch. Okay. It's clear. Sorry, I got a little distracted. Okay, it's a Death Rattle secret. You got two iron beaks? Okay, interesting. So what was I gonna say? So they create parody Dragon Ball Z episodes. And you can visit their website, which I'll be putting a link in the show notes, to see what sort of work they do. And I highly encourage you to do that. And they've had a pretty big YouTube presence for a while now. I think they've got about 2 million subscribers, and yesterday their channel went down. Now, usually when a channel goes down, it's as a result of copyright claims that, you know, the channel creators have used material that belongs to someone else, or belongs to, you know, either the creator or someone who has the license to distribute these things. And we don't know the full story, but the simple fact of the matter is the channel went down. And as of right now, and I will check because we have so much time, because my opponent seems to be taking forever to play. Team Four Star. As of recording, the channel has gone back up. Okay, interesting. So, something has happened between now and then. Do I want to use my Cobra, or do I want to use my? Let's use the Cobra. I can apply more damage to the face. It denies the second draw as well. I mean, either way, it's fine, I guess. There we go. So the channel has come back up, but for some reason, the channel went down. And it was down for a significant amount of time yesterday. I think it was down... I think it first went down... I'll have to do some research, but I think... So the channel came back up about 8 hours ago, and I think it was down for maybe, okay, so about 8 hours ago the channel came up, and about 24 hours ago this channel went down. Okay, so let me actually write this down. 24 hours ago channel went down, 8 hours ago channel returned. Okay, so you have silenced, so you've stealthed your water elemental. Interesting. I've got the beast in my sight. I think we just push for face damage. And I can divine shield this thing. And actually, the list probably needs a little bit of card draw. Probably could do with some card draw. Anyway, so the channel was down for roughly 16 hours. And this is a 2 million subscriber channel. This is, I'd imagine these guys derive a fair amount of their income and, you know, the way of living from a channel like this, because they've been building the channel for however long. And for some reason it was taken down. Now, we don't know the full story, but I do have to say that it just worries me that, how do you say, instead of taking down specific videos or targeting specific videos, YouTube, for some reason, the YouTube system decided to take the entire thing down in one go. It just worries me as someone who puts stuff up on YouTube. And it's pretty unlikely, actually, that the stuff that I make, because... Ooh, okay, we have Wind Fury Harpy. That's going to be nice. I should have... Oh, it doesn't make a difference whether I divine shield in the first or second. It's just... I don't know, I'm still trying to process the whole situation, but it just feels as if there could have been more communication between the parties, because it really did seem from... And I'll put a link to, you know, their Twitter, their YouTube... their website. I'll put a link to their Twitter, YouTube, and website in the show notes. But it really does seem as if it hit them by surprise. I could be wrong, obviously. Not on my watch. But, how do I say? It just seems like there was a breakdown of communication, and for some reason, instead of the whole channel got taken down, as opposed to, you know, just part of the channel going down, or part of the videos that were claimed going down. It just surprises me. And I just thought I'd note that because of how... It just seems like very ham-fisted, I think. And even, you know, not knowing the entire situation, it just seems very ham-fisted on YouTube's behalf that they would just take an entire 2 million subscriber channel down without at least first approaching the owners of the channel or the, you know, the creators of the channel and talking about, you know, hey, we have these issues, especially when it gets to a channel that big. Or maybe if you're like, you know, maybe if you've just got like a tiny channel and no one really watches it, but you upload, you know, pirated videos or copies of movies that recently released movies, sure, just take that down straight away. But when I mean, you have to, I think, I'm assuming that YouTube knows that a lot of people make a living off things like this. I don't know, I just thought I'd bring it up because it's quite interesting, you know, to follow these events. Anyway, back to actual brawling. Now, I think we need some card draw in this list, and because everything has taunt, there's going to be a lot of minion combat, so I wouldn't mind putting in a vigil. So I think that we do take out the harpy. I think we do take out the harpies. They're a little bit gimmicky. We'll take it out. We'll put in a vigil, and I will put in a cult master. Although the cult master itself will have taunt, so maybe just one cult master, one vigil. The hand of protections are also very. I'm gonna spend a lot of cards in my hand. You know what? Let's take out the bruise and put double cult, double vigil. And we do need some hardboard clears as well, actually. So now that I should focus on the game. Let's go with equality. We're going to need some hardboard clears. It does mean I need to take out some of my. The BGH is not seeing a lot of, yeah, because of my Emperor Cobras. So BGH is not seeing a lot of work. Hand of Prot. Now those silencers that the Mage was running were quite powerful also. I think I take out the Hand of Protections. We might even want to run Peacekeepers. We might even want to run a Peacekeeper because of the fact that everything has charge is just. Let's run one equality and then maybe double consecrate. Do I want double consecrate? I could probably do with another one drop, but it's just. Actually, I could run Blessing of Wisdom since I have a number of Divine Shield minions. Okay, let's run a Blessing of Wisdom. That doesn't work on turn one anyway, though. Could run a Finley. Well, let's try this for now, because I might as well take advantage of the fact that my minions will have Divine Shield. I might not even have enough early game for the Argent Protector to make sense. So we probably do want more early game. So maybe I'll take out some of my threes. Yeah, let's throw away the Worgens. I can't activate them myself. And the thing is, with the Taunt minions, they tend to be able to. They tend to have three or more attacks, so the Worgen is going to be hard to activate. Let's run some more early game. Okay, is there anything that I want to be able to charge and give taunt? Charge and give taunt. Let's just run some clockworks. Let's see how we go with the clockworks. Okay. Let's see if we can actually get a win this time. Warrior. Interesting. Very likely to be a bolster. Like, you know, because everything has taunt. I mean, I did think about the bolster warrior super combo, and that could work out. I think these two are worth keeping because they do so much work against the warrior's weapons. Okay, let's see how we go. And I do want to coin out the Divine Shield, the Shielded Mini-Bot, because I can follow up with Argent Protector. such a powerful thing. If Minibot had Taunt, that would be the most OP. If Minibot just came out with Taunt, not even Charge, it would be the most OP thing ever. Okay. Now, do I want to Divine Shield first or Divine Shield second? This is the question. Because if I Divine Shield second, Divine Shield first means it's protected from another hit. Divine Shield second, Divine Shield first means that it's at full health. Divine Shield second means it's a 2-1 with Divine Shield, which can be killed by Execute. I don't mind you using Execute on a 2-1, actually. So let's bait the Execute. I'm happy to bait the Execute here. Like, getting into Execute a 2-1 shielded minibot is actually a very good outcome. So I will take that. Ooh, you got a Frothing. Interesting. But we do have a clear on the Frothing, so that's good. The problem with the Frothing is the Frothing, it's very rare that you get to hit face. That's one thing I'm realizing with this brawl. Very hard to actually go face in this brawl. As long as there are minions up and you don't have like a big board clear, it's very hard to go face. Okay, so I don't think I need to develop the Cult Master. I think I can go minibot, minibot push the button. So something like Axe Flinger, which seems cute, but the only way you're going to win the board is by... The only way you're going to finish them off is by winning the board. Like doing a big board clear. The fact that it deals, you know, 2 damage or 4 damage total to my face, I don't think is that impactful. Okay, now what I can do here is actually use the Abusive to run in. I could have drawn 2 cards, actually. But I think we have a fairly good amount of cards in hand. What I could have done was Silver Hand in, and then Abusive on the Minibot. Okay, so there's your Black Knight, which is fine. That's definitely something I would run too. Seal of Champs? Or we can just go Scarlet run in. Yeah, I think Scarlet run in is fine. And I can Seal of Champs a Silver Hand recruit, actually. And it becomes super protected because we have 2 taunts in front of it. Very swingy brawl, this one. Very, very swingy brawl. Yeah. Oh, I didn't have Stalag. Stalag could have, like, smashed him in the face for 7. Yeah, very, very swingy brawl. You definitely want to be running probably something like Brawl here. Brawl, yeah. Brawl in a brawl. That makes sense. Okay. Are we done? No, it hits for 8. Not quite done. Okay. Let's trade this in. Is there a way we can finish? I can go 4 plus 3. That's 7. That's 11 damage. We're just 1 off. No, you got 13. We're 2 off. Okay. Well, then let's just play... Let's do it this way. I want to build a big black blood knight. Oh, actually, oh, I didn't see the blood knight. Yeah, okay. So that's one thing I didn't notice. Blood knight lethal because of divine shield. So that's one thing that you do need to realize if you're playing paladin with blood knights. You can get blood knight lethal, which I did not realize. So you can, okay, so you gain a 3 attack buff to the Blood Knight. You can play like a combo Blood Knight list. Okay, so we've got our win. Let's try a Bolster Warrior, actually. Yeah, let's try a Bolster Warrior. Let's try a Bolster Warrior. Okay, here we are. So obviously we're going to want Bolster. You don't need to give anything taunt because everything has taunt. I'm going to want some bigger board clears or even just efficient removal. Efficient removal is going to be very useful here. It's going to be... Ooh, Commanding Shout could work as well. Because there's going to be so much minion combat, it may be worth running things like that. Yeah. Cruel Task is going to be great because everything has charge. Armorsmith itself has taunt. That's the issue with Armorsmith. Because it gets cleared first up. We could grind some King's Defenders. I don't think they're that... I don't think they're that strong, actually. We have the bolster. The Frothing itself also has taunt. That's the problem. Yeah, everything comes to the front of the list. Your charge minions have one attack. Does this actually have a spot? I wonder. I am going to run Double Brawl. Because you fall behind very much so. It's very easy to fall behind. Grimash already has charge. We do want to run Divine Minions, Divine Shield stuff again. And I might... Yeah. So charge things that already have... We run a Blood Knight. Yeah. I think I'll even run Silent Knight. Force Tank is fine. So we've got good removal. We've got good comeback with the Double Brawl, Execute Shield Slams. Weapons are going to be pretty good as well because the minions are sitting at the front. There's nothing you won't be able to hit with a weapon. So knowing that, I will take a war. AoE board clear is going to be really useful as well. Yeah, let's take the cleave. Let's take a war axe. King's Defender is okay, I guess, on turn 3. And I could take a Death Bite. And then maybe a Gore Howl. I think the Gore Howl will be too slow. At that stage of the game, I'll be taking too much damage from minions charging into my face. Battle Rage. Bolst. Commanding. It might even be worth running a Pyro to do some Battle Rage combos. Okay, let's see if we can run a Pyro. Although the Pyro will be pretty bad if I end up pyroing my own Divine Shield minions. Which is... Yeah. Actually, I think I'll take the Squires out because... They're too slow. Not that they're too slow, it's just... They don't do enough, even in this mode, because they just charge for one, which isn't great. Which gives me some space to run... Oops. What did I take out? I don't know. That's okay. We'll figure it out. Oh no, I think no, the King's Defender is still here. Who knows? I'll have to go back into the video and check. What else are we looking at? That's what came out, Blood Knight. So we'll put the Blood Knight back in. And we do have the Pyro for the big board clears, I think. Could probably go... That's right, we could use Cobras as well, but maybe I'll just run a Myxna. Because of how much health it has. I think the Cobras themselves... At that stage of the game, you might even only want one Cobra. Yeah, so let's run one Myxna, one Cobra. One Emperor Cobra. Because two... You don't actually want to play the Cobra on turn 3. Because whatever it runs into is probably going to have enough attack to kill it. You want it to run it... You want to play it late game to... get a straight up kill on something. Okay. Oh, actually, that's right. We got the Stalag and Fugan brothers. Which. Okay. Maybe I can take out. That's right. The Force Tanks, I think, are a little too slow. Let's try Stalag and Fugan. Alright, let's try this list. Now, it did occur to me that we might actually want to run something like Zoo Bolster. I don't want the Pyro. The Silent Knight is okay, I guess. Yeah, something like a Zoo Bolster list. So, we flood the board, and then you get a huge Bolster off. And then Bolster actually behaves like, Bolster then behaves like, a Bloodlust. Or a Bloodlust, or a Savage Roar. Let's actually try that after this game. So I'll put in more early game, less removal, except weapons. I think, yeah, I'll use my weapons for removal and then try to get off a huge bolster. painful. Missing the two drop is very painful as well. But that's okay. Ooh, taking a ton of damage. I may actually have to just charge the Cobra into the combatant. Can't have that hitting me in the face a second time, I think. And it's actually a not bad target, because you innovated out the combatant, so the Cobra going in. But we may be far behind. Yeah, okay. Ah, so you can push out with the... Oh, okay. Yeah, we may be dead. We may be dead, but it's hard to say. We do have the Brawl to come back. But these super high attack minions are going to be a problem. Yeah, the Brawl probably even too slow in this mode. Yeah, I'm just getting rushed down. Okay. I think we go more aggressive. Yeah, I think I've gone about this the wrong way. Okay, Stalag. He barely survives. But Hero Power to my face, or even Swipe to my face, and Big Game Hunter. Yeah, I think I was trying to play it. I was building a too balanced deck. Let's try. Okay, I think we're done. You Hero Powering up? Yeah, we're done. I'm going to try a more aggressive bolster list. So we may even use the... Yeah, more aggressive bolster with attack buffs and stuff, like a zoo bolster. Okay, so let's take out some of our late game, because ideally we don't even reach it. Silver Moon is fine. I think in this case, the Divine Shield of the Argent Squire is good too. We probably want Abusive. Now, what do I have in the form of card draw? That's right. Cult Master is going to be good here. So I could even... Battle Rage... I don't know how likely I am to get Battle Rage off. I could Commanding Shout combo into Battle Rage. Cleave is probably too reactive. So let's put in Cults. Pyro is too reactive as well. King's Defender is fine. Death's Bite is fine. Because ideally I'm using these weapons to clear the board while my minions go face. Commanding is also fine. Cruel Task. What are my other draw mechanics? Acolyte can work. I feel Acolyte is too slow. So we've got 4-1 drops. We've only got 2-2 drops, which is really worrying. I probably want something like a Direwolf. Yeah. Or even an armor. No, Armorsmith is too slow. Alex Straz's chat. No, that's not going to work. I think we go Direwolf. And actually, I wonder how things like Ancient Watchers interact with Give a Minion Charge and Taunt. I wonder. It might be worth doing some research. Okay. Even huge toads would work well. Perhaps the silver moons are too slow. Yeah, let's take out the silver moons and put in Dark Irons. Okay, let's see how we go with this list. And hopefully we can take... The idea is to take board advantage early. Shield Slam may not even have a place to Shield Slam here because I'm not gaining any armor. Which means that maybe we have space for a Reaper. Yeah, Reaper will deal a ton of damage to face as well. Okay, let's see how we go with this more aggressive bolster list. Okay, against a priest, we do want the one. The Direwolf can help. Don't know how much space the Cruel Tars. Yeah, let's just keep our low drops because that's the whole point of starting quickly. Ooh, the bolster is going to be really, really useful. Okay. Hopefully this turns out. I mean, this works out for us. Okay. Ooh, excellent. Argent Squire going to be very, very good for trading, especially since I have things like Direwolves and Abusives. The question is, do I have enough card draw in this list? And we will have to find out. Okay. Let's go. I'm going to try and save the bolster for as long as possible. So at the moment, it gives me four. So two mana bolster gives me four worth of stats. We're going to charge into that. That's fine. We can still abusive up. Is it worth pushing the early bolster? Or do I want to be greedy? No, I think it's worth pushing this early bolster. Because my board may get cleared next turn. Or at least one of my minions may get cleared. And plus this enables me to crawl task up. So hopefully that was the correct decision. I mean, a bolster to give me 4-4 is fine. Getting 4-4 worth of value for 2 is fine. You'd obviously want more, but I think that was it's too greedy to go for more. Okay, Iron Beak is fine. Ah, oh, Bomber. That's a nice defensive option. Interesting. Okay. I think what I do is Cruel Task, Coin Crusader. Because then it allows me to not have to Cruel Task my own Crusader. And we are running low on cards, so that does indicate to me we probably want a little more card draw. But only the first game, let's see how we go. Yeah, Sheep is actually really good. Didn't realize. Explosive Sheep's Deathrattle are very good. Yeah, the Cruel Task, you need more minions for the Cruel Task to work. But we're still significantly ahead in terms of the health race, but I am running out of resources. That's all you've got? There's gotta be more. Really? Really? Okay, well, I'm going to push some damage to your face then. That was a really, really slow turn 6. Okay, you got Boom. Actually, this will answer some of my questions. So the Boom bots don't gain charge. Interesting. But the Boom itself does. Okay, so summon minions don't gain charge. That's good to know. And I will draw a card. I will preserve the Divine Shield of my... I will preserve the Divine Shield of my Argent Squire. So that's one thing to know. Science equals summoned minions, e.g. boom bots, do not gain charge and taunt. Only the minion that was quote unquote played. Okay. That's good to know. Ooh, you have to heal yourself now, I think. Yeah. I think we're done. Yeah. I think that my opponent had to put something on the board. Otherwise, like... Yeah. Actually, the Darkhind is really, really aggressive. Because Darkhind... The thing with Darkhind is if you can play two minions in one turn... Yeah, it makes attack buff minions super powerful. So, another thing to note. Attack buff minions are super strong. Which probably also means that... Shattered Sun Clerics are probably strong also. I think I might even want to take out the Silent Knights for Shattered Suns. Because not only are you able to give the buff to a minion that's charging, the minion itself has charge. This is actually much stronger than... I mean, the Silent Knight is very defensive, which can be good, and which also combos well with things like Blood Knight. Okay, but you know what? I'm going to get rid of this... Oh, actually, I do want to do some science. I do want to do some science. And I do want to do an experimental game to see whether... So we have figured out that summon minions cannot attack. But I do want to see whether Ancient Watcher gains the attack. So, to do some science, I'm going to run Warlock, because then it gives me a chance to... And plus, these minions aren't actually that bad, because they automatically gain Taunt. So, for science, this final couple games... So, for science, Warlock... We're giving them... We're putting in minions that can't attack. They already gain Taunt. Which probably means I can play a defensive list using things such as... egg. Where's the egg? Where are those eggs? Here we go. Both the eggs. We're going to put in... We're going to make a not... A can't attack list. Okay. Does it mean... What if they really just can't attack? Do I need to silence them? I guess we will find out. And there's nothing that I can hide behind the taunts, because everything is automatically given... given taunt and charge. So there's nothing you can hide. Ooh, this is probably going to be really strong, because you can charge a minion and then Void Terror to eat the minion and charge again. That's probably insane. Wow. Okay, let's try that. What else is there that I could probably use? We do want some board clears, so let's run some Demon Wraths and some Hellfires. They give me a chance to try these card attack minions. We can do it for science. And what else is there? Actually, yeah, give attack. Give attack is still really strong in this mode. That's assuming that it works in the way... I don't know. I'm not sure. That's why we're doing this game. Okay. And what else can we do? Divine Shield again. Yeah, let's just do the good old Divine Shield nonsense again. I'm not going to run these guys because I think they're still a little slow for what they do. And we can run up. Yeah, we've got the Blood Knight. Okay. And we don't need any card draw because of the Warlock Hero Power. And we're starting actually fairly quickly. And with the eggs, I might actually want a Direwolf again. Yeah, and the Direwolf itself is very useful because... Much like the Abusive Sergeant, it gives the one attack to... If you're able to combo with something else, you gain three attack from the Direwolf. Which means I can probably go Shattered Sun again. And we do have some good board clears. So... But let's try one more board clear. We can run a Shadow Flame and see how we go. Yeah. It seems like you don't really need much direct removal in this mode. Because everything has taunt, you can just play a minion as direct removal. So that's one thing to note also. So direct removal. So the thing, what am I talking about? I'm talking about things like Dark Bomb / Shadow Bolt. Because you can... is underpowered in this mode. Because you can just play a 2-drop that has 3 attack. Yeah. Okay, well, I'm keeping the Eerie Statue because I want to try it out for science. Yeah, so direct removal like Dark Bomb, Shadow Bolt, even Fireball is okay, but you could run, what's a 4-attack minion that has 6, I mean, 4 mana minion that has 6 attack. I think Fireball just edges it out, but, you know, you could run the Salty Dog, which is a 7-4, 5 or 7-4, and that's like 7 damage removal, direct removal. Which makes things like Scarlet Crusader really useful, actually. Okay. The light protects me. So. I fight. Yeah, and Divine Shield. I think the definite MVPs of this brawl are the Divine Shield minions, the attack buff minions, and what else is there? Actually, yeah, Explosive Sheep also. Oh, you forgot to attack. Interesting. Let's just push through. Now let's see what happens to the egg. The egg is not going to be able to attack, that's for sure. Yeah, with no attack value, you cannot attack. But I wonder if the same goes for Eerie Statue, that, you know, that gains the can't attack. Actually, I don't know about Eerie Statue. I don't know about the interaction between Eerie Statue. But let's see how we go. Okay. Scarlet or Direwolf? I think Scarlet is a better use of my mana for now, although Direwolf would have summoned me a dragon egg. I mean, would have summoned me a dragon. And I don't think the dragon itself is given charge and taunt. I think it needs to be played from your hand. Much like that Dr. Boom, like that Dr. Boom that my opponent played last game. Okay. Let's try this. Nope, can't attack. Alright, so it doesn't override. The charge and taunt buff doesn't override Eerie Statue. But the stats on the statue and the auto taunt is very strong. Like, the fact that you can just play the statue and it's a 7-7 taunt for 4, that's ridiculous. So there's no reason not to play the statue, actually, if you're playing a more defensive, control-y game. There really is no reason not to play the statue. I don't think that was a good idea. Oh, okay, you're going to spend the charge. Alright, sure. This works. So we can charge our eggs into the elephant, hatching them, and then push out. And we actually have a fair amount of burst in hand, because I can hit for 7, and then eat them, and then hit for 7 plus 3, which is 10. So that's 17 damage burst with the Void Terror, if it works like I think it works. Which probably also makes things like Frostwolf Warlord pretty decent, but it's unlikely you're going to have a big, large amount of minions on the board with the Warlord. Okay, quick shot. Okay, sure. I still have a fair amount of burst here, though. Not so much anymore, because, yeah, the Void Terror still is a little bit board dependent. Okay, let's tap. It's not great to have the... Okay, let's push out with the Blood Knight. It's not actually great. I probably have too many board clears. Yeah. Probably have too many board clears in this list. I have no time for games. So, Science Warlock versus... Hunter. Okay. We will Hellfire here, though. Something like a Sylvanas. Sylvanas is very strong also. Okay. Do I just want to push? No. I think... Okay, that's good. I think we... I mean, yeah, let's play it for control. I want to see whether it's the same interaction with Haunted What's-Its-Face. Sorry, not Haunted. Here we are, Ancient Watcher. All right, I don't think the Ancient Watcher will gain charge. Actually, playing the Ancient Watcher now may lose me the game, so I think we have to play more... Oh, no, yeah. We do have to play more straight up. I'll try the Watcher next turn. Plus, the Ancient Watcher actually gives the Void Terror a ton of damage. The problem is that the Watcher itself doesn't charge. I'm assuming it doesn't charge phase. If it does, it'll be really, really powerful. I'm assuming that the text of the card itself overrides the buff that it's given. So we will have to see. Okay, skill command. Oh, you're going to skill command face. Okay. Another skill command to the face? Not quite enough. Okay. We may lose, but that's okay. We're doing this all for science. Okay. Well, let's try Rag, because it does the same thing. Yeah. I don't think Rag is going to gain charge. No. Can't attack. Okay, so that's another piece of science as well. Doesn't work on Brag / Ancient Watcher. The charge taunt buff doesn't override. Oh, okay. Oh, we're done. Well, let's try it. I didn't get to try it. I'm assuming it does the same thing. So Ancient Watcher's not incredible, but still pretty good for pumping up your Void Caller. I think actually a secret MVP. I mean, Ancient Watcher is still very defensive, so it's not too bad. Which means Argent Watchman, it kind of sucks. Kind of sucks as well. But Ancient Watcher is still very, very defensive because it automatically gains taunt. So it's worth considering if you're playing a defensive list. But then again, you could just run Egg. You could just run Egg or Dragon Egg, and they're very defensive options as well, which give you protection from AoE. The Eerie Statue, however, is really, really interesting because of the fact that you don't need it to attack. It's a 4-mana 7-7 taunt. And if you're able to eat it with a Void Terror... Actually, let's try one more game because I do want to see about the Void Terror synergies. I want to test the Void Terror synergies. So I did take out the Watchman because these things don't actually work anymore. Like we figured out the science that the Argent Watchman doesn't work. Rag doesn't work. Although Rag giving him auto-taunted Rag is pretty nice. 4 board clears is probably a bit much. Let's go with 2. Actually, I'll go with 2 plus Shadow Flame. So that's 3 board clears. We have a little bit of space in the list. The Ancient Watches are still nice, actually. I still want, like, playing them on turn 2 is still going to be quite nice because of the how defensive they are. They give you a ton of stats for what they do. And plus, it sets up a big Voidwalker synergy. Okay. What else do we like? Actually, it turns out that Wind Fury isn't actually that powerful in this mode because of the low stats of the Wind Fury minions. I think it's just like they're really underpowered. Let's see if we can actually find some other Deathrattle minions. The Explosive Sheeps, actually. Yeah. So instead of running Hellfire, I can just run Explosive Sheep and even Demon Wrath. But Demon Wrath, I'm not running any demons. I'm running like one demon. Okay. Yeah, we can just run double Explosive Sheep. That does a better job of it. And what else might synergize with our... with this sort of list? I guess a Sky Golem could work. Because it automatically gains taunt, and then the thing that pops out of the sky, the thing you have to note is the thing that pops out of the sky golem doesn't have taunt, so you have a 4-drop that's protected by the rest of your board. That's actually really interesting. Okay, so let's run Anubisath just for funsies, and let's see if we can pull off a big Void Terror combo. Alright, let's go one more game. Okay, I'm happy to keep the Watcher on 2. I think we can lose the Dark Iron. Alright, let's see how we go. The main thing is I want to get Eerie Statue Voidwalker combo off. I mean, Void Terror. There we go. We have the Void Terror. So even if I'm going to lose, I can actually... Oh, crap. Whoops. That was silly. Okay, that's one thing to remember. Always remember you can attack first with minion before ending turn. All right. And the cute thing about this is... With the abusive, I send the abusive in instead of sending in the... Okay, and I do want to coin out the egg. Coined out egg sets up... okay, good. The egg doesn't attack. Yeah, don't automatically end the turn. That's just a habit that I guess you develop as a Hearthstone player because, you know, there's nothing for you to do. But you forget, I forget that the minions... Ooh, okay, that's dangerous. The minions... Let's develop the Sentinel. Again, no charge on the Watcher. But we can push out the Eerie Statue and go for a big OTK. Actually, it won't. It's probably not going to work because of how many taunts are going to be sitting on the board. Oh, really? You're going to silence my Watcher? Because then it gives the Watcher... it gives the Watcher the ability to attack, which is interesting. Okay. You know what? Let's play a little defensively with our Eerie Statue. Because you spent both owls there, so you're not going to be able to owl the taunt of my Eerie Statue. And it's so many stats for the price. A very, very strong 4-drop. Yeah. And plus, I can eat whatever I need to eat next turn to push a ton of damage to your face. I don't think it was a good idea to silence the Watcher, actually. I think I would have just cleared it with the Blood Knight. Interesting. Okay. Yeah, it turns out this Brawl has a little bit more to it than meets the eye, but I think that's the case with most Brawls. Just, again, a little disappointed that it's a... Oh, you've got to attack. It's a... How do you say? Little disappointed that it's a collection-dependent Brawl, as I said before. Okay. Now, I can... Hit, hit. Hmm.
I wonder.
You call that a weapon?
Okay, I think I do this.
Get in there, fight, maggot.
Yeah, I don't want to go for my super combo just yet. And you forgot to attack with your ogre. I don't know whether that was intentional or not, but we'll see. Yeah, so surprisingly strong cards. This one, the Explosive Sheep, surprisingly strong because you can deal 3 damage to one minion and 2 damage to the rest of their board, which is a really, really efficient board clear for 2 mana. Oh, interesting. Okay. I'm going to push into my... Yeah, okay. Oh, okay. So he's going to double trade. Okay, that works. Very expensive clear, though. Okay. I think I tap Direwolf. We'll just blank Dark Iron. So obviously I want to win this game, but... if worst comes to worst and I'm going to lose, I'm just going to try the Void Terror combo. I'm assuming it's going to work because of the mechanics of the brawl, but you never know. Okay, is the power overwhelming? Oh, wow. Okay, you're going to Void Terror? Oh, there it is. So we can actually see if it works on this side. So the Void Terror... Ooh, 10-6. That's really cool. Can I gain 6? No, I can't. I think we're done. Yeah. No, it's not enough. All right. Well played. Yeah. Well, at least we figured out Void Terror combo works great. So any minions that give buffs or buff themselves based on the board state, really, really powerful because that effect turns into burn. Okay, we did play 7 games and only won 3, but that's okay. We got to do a lot of science and figure out a lot of things. Okay, so let's finish up there. Thanks in advance, guys, for liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing. I do this for love. Any gestures of appreciation, much appreciated. So I hope you enjoyed the Tavern Brawl shenanigans, and I will be back in the near future with some more Hearthstone, probably some more budget Shaman ladder climbing. So until then, this is No Dust signing off.